President Dakai Ndejirema has continued to make pronouncements that he is going to govern and ensure that the rule of law prevails. He's going to govern under the principle of the rule of law, and that he will make sure that the rule of law prevails. But unfortunately, slightly over 100 days of him being in office, it has turned out that actually under his leadership, it is the rule of gangsters that is prevailing. It so happened that I was a victim to that kind of behavior by UPND members, UPND officials, and government officials. Remember that a few days ago, a week or so ago, I was summoned to the police. And the unfortunate part thing is that a minister in the name of Mike Mposha led hooligans, thugs, to come to the police station to come and cause mayhem, which is unprecedented. That is the rule of gangsters. People who don't even fear the police. With impunity, he came and caused the mayhem that is in public domain. A few days ago, we had the UPND thugs go to storm Zambezi Portlands on the Copper Belt, demanding that they want to inspect all their warehouses and storage facilities without any regard to the law. And what is even more perplexing is that a government official in the name of a district commissioner was in the forefront leading these hooligans to break locks, open forcefully all the storage facilities for Zambezi Portlands without any court order or indeed any warrant. This can only but speak to the fact that now we are under the law or the rule of gangsters. We expected that the president would speak to those issues, but the very loud silence from the president and from government officials, from the police, is highly, highly worrying. Beyond that, we are aware that now the media has become the second target. The Minister of Information has begun to summon media houses to intimidate media houses that seem to be covering the opposition and wanting to coerce them or indeed to begin to give them a script according to UPND on how the opposition should be engaged by the media. That is very unfortunate and it should not be condoned. Beyond that, we are aware that there are cases that the police have been vigorously pushed to investigate and pursue. One, the case of the death of Mapenzi, and the other one is the death of Vespa. As far as we're concerned as Patriotic Front, any life lost, regardless of the circumstances, even if there is a perception, for example, that Mapenzi and Vespa were UPND sympathizers, we demand that justice prevails, because there is no life that is worth losing just because of politics or any other consideration. But would love that the same way the UPND government are insisting that the police should investigate matters and cases that were committed in time past, they must also begin to investigate and pursue matters that are and case, you know, offenses that are being committed now. What is of great concern is also the double standard. Whilst in relation to Vespa, in relation to Mapenzi, there is a push that justice prevails. When it comes to Mr. Kungo, who died in Solwezi, information through the binocracy that is reaching us suggests that there is interference in wanting to have justice aborted. One of the prime suspects, one of the prime witnesses, apparently is reported or alleged to be here in Lusaka, moved from Solwezi by one of a non-security personnel of UPND, of the UPND party, a gentleman that is popularly known as Mufwai, who is, as it we speak now, is being accommodated at Paramount Motel. And the young lady who took a video that actually helps to identify the perpetrators of that heinous act that led to the death of Mr. Kungo, equally is alleged or reported to also be in Lusaka and also accommodated at Paramount Motel. Our fear is that possibly the Hatembo saga is going to repeat itself, where the cause of justice is aborted through the process of abduction, compromising witnesses. We want to call upon the police, the command in Northwestern Province, plus the command here in Lusaka, to investigate these matters and ensure that those who are to aid and help the police and later on the court to bring to book those who are responsible for those deaths must not be interfered with or indeed end up disappearing in thin air. May they protect their witnesses. May they look into these matters. We have some names of members of parliament that are involved in this whole scam, but we want to make sure that the facts that were presented are such that none of them can deny their involvement. So in the next day or so, we should be able to give more details. But I can confirm that these two individuals, the security person who transported the other witness, they are at Paramount Motel as we speak today. So I thought we could just speak to the fact that President Hakainde must own up to his word, at least for the first time, let him fulfill this promise of allowing that this country is governed by the rule of law, not the rule of gangsters. That's why we're having the likes of William Banda, with impunity, begin to warn and threaten people that are planning to join in the campaigns of Patriotic Front in Kawata. What kind of behavior is that? If Ms. Hakainde was serious about the rule of law, these are characters that should have already been caged by now if you're serious. But you notice that every time a UPND member or members do something that is unlawful, there is a deafening silence on the part of the president, on the part of the party, and on the part of government. Are you telling me that Ms. Hakainde Hichilema hasn't listened to what William is saying? Are you telling me Ms. Hakainde Hichilema hasn't witnessed or seen what has happened at Zambezi Portland? Are you telling me that he didn't see what happened at Cheston Police? And at Cheston Police, he had his minister in the forefront. And his own deputy IG, Mr. Sendenge, was also at Cheston Police. So what kind of governance of the country is this, apart from the fact that it's a rule of gangsters? Thank you very much, and God bless.